Hello, we are build informed. Of course, you can visit us. Yeah, we are in the BIM area, hall 3.2, on the booth A3.024. Anyhow, BIM area, it's 3D, you will find it. Come to us, visit us, would be great. So, let's start. BIM from point clouds, it can be done automatically. You press the button and it's popping up here. Yeah? Imagine you have a point cloud, you press, AI is doing this anyhow, overnight, elements are coming, model is coming to the birth. In the end, you have your model. Would be a wonderful dream. But to be honest, it's not. It's not existing. I will show you how we do models. I will show you some models we do. We make it by hand, but step by step, yeah? I will talk about the overall process, how they are be done by us. Yeah? In the beginning, somebody wants BIM. Then we get point clouds, and then we come to the black box, to this metamorphosis, and at the end, we have a model. So in the beginning, somebody wants BIM. It's a fancy new stuff. Yeah, it's really interesting, so let's do it. Yeah, and very soon, you come to the point, what should be inside? Yeah, so can I show you our loin? And we're not talking about the loin here. We're talking about the level of information need. What should be in the model? To explain this, I have a slide. It's in German, but I explain it. One hand is geometrical information. We have to discuss, for example, how looks the door, yeah? Which details I have inside. Yeah? Another stuff is the alphanumeric information, which parameters and attributes I want to have in the model and for what, and at the end, in which format I deliver all the model and, very important, why I'm doing this, the Anwendungsziel. So we have our own loin. For every project we start, we bring this to the table, we take the customer with us and say, what do you need? Yeah? Let's talk about all this geometric and alphanumeric information. It takes some time, but it's really necessary. And out of this, for example, a model we did, yeah, it's a history museum, it's a heritage building, so we had to discuss the heritage needs. We have to integrate it, and I have to say it looks quite nice. Yeah? I modeled by myself also in this. We have a lot of details. And so when we have the information, the loin, then it's your turn, the surveyors are starting, we are not surveying, we're just modeling. Surveyors are making a point cloud. Here we can see already these colors. It's our quality check, I will show it later on again. And yeah, we get the point clouds, and also what's really important for us is a viewer. So we can see in the viewer much more details we cannot recognize in the point cloud. And also I have to mention for the client, it's wonderful. We had some architects, they got a viewer for a big plant, and I said, it's great. Yeah, you go inside, you see everything you have to see very easy in a point cloud, you cannot do it because it's too heavy. So again, the point cloud is coming, a model should be come out of it. Here we have a heat, district heating plant, it's called. Yeah, we did. And now it comes to us, yeah? We get the point cloud, and I will talk now about this black box, the metamorphosis. It's our turn, we are a BIM manufacturer, and of course, as I said, press the button, it's not working. I will show you why. Before, who are we? We are build informed. We are located in Tyrol, in the Alps, in Innsbruck. You can see it here. We are existing since 2015. We are around 20 people. As you know already, we are doing modeling, but also we make courses for Revit, for BIM. We're making consulting like BIM management and coordination. We have a solution for the twin, and we make CAD/CAM automatization. If you want, come to us. I can show you some examples. Why do I have expertise in modeling? Over the last years, we made over 1 million square meters in modeling, around 160 football fields. And it's not only about architecture, it's also infrastructure and MEP, plumbing, ducts, electricity and so on, topography, all the disciplines. So now we come to the point how we make these models. Yeah? And I'll show you the steps. First, we get the point clouds. We transfer them. We make a setup. Then we model. At the end, we have the quality check. Imagine this is the point cloud. Yeah? First of all, we get it from you. We shift it in local coordinates. Yeah? We use Revit. That's the point, important. We try to work in georeference systems. It was a nightmare. Stuff was shifting and so on. We always go in a local system. Then we slice it, for example, by stories or by districts. And we bake it together because we don't need a few scans. For us, it's enough if you have one cloud, can be subsampled, and we can bring it to Revit. Next step, as we say in German, eine gute Vorbereitung ist die halbe Miete. I don't know if you have it in English. Similar proverb. At the beginning, we have a template. We have special components like doors and walls and so on. We need for this, yeah, so we can speed up. We define stories and zones. We bring the point clouds in. And we prepare our BIMAC. It's a BIM accuracy control where we compare model and clouds. So let's start. Team is starting. Very important. We had to learn this over the years. Don't mix it up here. If you have, for example, ground floor and first floor, one person is making this area. Don't mix it up here, because one person knows what she did already. Here, for example, Verena. And also, if you're in complex point clouds, you have to go through and through. And at the end, you know everything by heart, every corner, every wall. And that's important knowledge. And now gets interesting. Now we see how we model. We are in the Revit, as you can see. The person is preparing the stories. Think about how can we make it. And it's worth to spend an hour to have some thoughts. Then he's placing the walls, and it's all by hand. Yeah? We take a look. How big is the wall? Is it fitting? He has a lot of walls. And also the point clouds, looking a bit colorful, we switch always to the normal mode because we can see the orientation of the points much more better. And so again, when you have the walls, you go to the next step, you place the doors, for example. And here we have a tool we made by our own. We want to see immediately if you're working accurate or not. So we call it the live BIMAC. You press it, you can see it, okay, the wall is green, it's fine, it's accurate. And you can go on. You're modeling, and then you should make it sure fix. Yeah? It sounds very easy, but communication during this process is very important. You have always surprises, questions rising up, or you didn't think about some points. Yeah? So we schedule regular meetings with the client. We show how the model is looking like. We discuss it, and then we go on. Sounds very easy, but we had to learn this, yeah? And it's really worth to do it. And now we come to the question, why do we make it by hand? You might find some software vendors, yeah? There are some solutions, and the answer is quite easy. We had a big plan, we used the automatic solution, and the question is, what do you see here? I see railings of a stair. The software was seeing pipes. So we brought it in, we had a lot of pipes in the model, and we said, shit, what are the good pipes and what are the bad ones? And perhaps the pipes on top we are missing. And in the end, you spend more time cleaning up the model. And we said, let's do it by hand. We tried some other solutions like Faro as Build, what is semi-automatic, what is working much more better. Sometimes we use it, sometimes not. Depends. Yeah. But we don't make all by hand. If you can use Dynamo. And now take a look here. Here, now it's showing up. We have a lot of curves. You can make it by hand, but you can use Dynamo, grab the line of the floor, and generate this geometry. And this is really speeding up. This, what we saw before, was from a real example. Here we say a train station in Offenbach. And here you can get an image what is all inside, all the stairs, railway lines, and details. Also, if you want to bring information automatically inside, here an example, we have a list of rooms with the information. We have a Dynamo script, we have the model, and we can bring it together. And like this, we can bring a lot of data automatically inside. And I call it automatic data enrichment. Anyhow, if you want to buy a Dynamo script, we offer it in our shop. Take a look, it's not really expensive. Between 0 and 5, feel free to take a look, bimag.ag/shop. Okay, let's say we are making this model, we are finished. We use Kanban, or in this, it's a picture from Jira, and we have a Kanban board, and we say we have different steps. Now we're going from work in progress into the quality control. And again, we have a principle, never trust the modeler. The guy who modeled the first floor, for example, he shouldn't control himself. It's stupid, yeah? Doesn't make sense. So here, another person is taking over, and she's doing the control. It means you take the model, you take a look inside, you make sections, go through, and very important, I talked about our tool, BIM Accuracy Control. We always take at the end a model, we take a point cloud, and we compare the difference and make a heat map. So we can see immediately where we have deviations, where is the stuff missing, and like this we can be sure it's accurate. Anyhow, we offer this as a service. If you're interested, come to our booth and we can show you more about this BIM Accuracy Control. Good? Passed. Okay. So, the model is done. We made a check. We made the BIMAC. We know it's accurate. It's cool. So, it's going to done. And that's the end effect of the metamorphosis here. From a point cloud, we get out a model. For the client, it's over. For us, not. Because always after a project, we make a lessons learned here. What to start, what to keep, what to stop, yeah. In every project, you're developing some scripts, some new ideas, some new workflows, and after 1 or 2 weeks later, after the finish, we make these lessons learned.